Good afternoon to Miss Adeline and my fellow classmates. Today I'm going to present about my authentic professional summary board. So in order to do this assessment, I have answered 4 questions, which in 3 stages. What am I and what should I be representing my professional identification stage? And second is, how should I be it in the second stage, which is professional identity development stage? And third, why it should be this way represents the professional identity transformation stage. So I have conducted Honey and Mumford test questionnaire, and my answer for that is reflective. The Elvison's framework of self-identity metaphors is, I have conducted these 2 to relate into my experiences, and I have selected 3 metaphors, which is sea, cloud, and grass, as my my personal metaphors, and also testimonies from my best friend and my ex-colleagues to draw out my Johalin window, and some proverbs, poetry, and quotes from books I have put inside too. So here comes stage 1, which is my first metaphor. I have selected sea as it because sea has no shape, because it have a very many possibility in it. It represents my past, which I was small. I can be anything, right? So I'm actually the only child. I was the only child in my family, which I have a 9-year-old sister younger than me. So when I was small, I was grown up alone. And both of my parents are busy, so I have brought up by my aunt, but she seldom like talk to me. So most of my time I was spending with my toys, and slowly I read books, I listen to music, but I seldom talk. So because of that, I do not know how to express my thoughts and my feelings to other people. So people would think that I'm quiet and I don't want to share, but in fact, it's just, I don't know how to tell. So it makes me hard to make friends when I was small. Now it's a bit okay, but I'm still putting effort in that. So I actually like to be alone rather than in a crowd. I really enjoy to spend time with reading books and browse internet and play games. These are the things that I usually do in my adolescence time. So, but luckily, when I was 7, my mother has forced me to learn piano, and I really hated it for the first few years because it's really hard and very boring to learn those theories and techniques. But slowly, I feel that that's the only way I can express my feeling when I have many thoughts, and I don't know how to tell people, so I just play with my piano. Yeah. My best friend has pointed out, she wrote a testimony for me. She said, I doesn't talk much, and never be the one who start a conversation when I don't know some people. And the first impression she thinks of me is, I'm a very arrogant people. Yeah, but she stated that she know that's wrong. I'm actually not that kind of person, but just I seldom talk, so people would think like I'm arrogant. So I related what she wrote to me, and with the Honey and Mumford questionnaire, my result is reflector, which reflector represents a person that tend to observe responses from others, and they make up their mind slowly. They are low profile and keep distance to observe rather than taking the lead, which I think that's really represents me. Yeah. So here comes the stage 2, which the clouds. I have picked this because cloud can have many of shapes, and I think that's represents me because I think I have much of possibility to be in any kind of people. I'm not with, I'm not stressed in my adolescent time, because my parents, they do not judge all my results, and they never ask about my homework. Like, hey, do you have any homework to do? They never ask. Mm-hmm. They just come back after they work, then they ask me, do you eat? Or that's all. Nothing. So I never really study. And it affects my result become extreme. Like, I can score A's in Chinese subject, in maths, in science, but I can fail my Malay language. I can fail certain subjects that I don't like, I'm not interested in. So I was very happy at first, because my classmates, they told me that I've been scolded by my parents because of my result. I think, oh, that's great, my parents did not judge me. But when I was in primary six, I've been scolded by my teacher in front of my classmates, and I felt shame, because I never been scolded before by anyone. So I started to blame on my parents. I think they don't really like care about me. So other than that, I don't need to do house course. So it affected later in my university life, because I'm bad in time management. I just enjoy my time in my adolescence. So I realized that I need to change when I was 16 years old, because most of my friends, they are talking about, oh, I want to be a pilot, I want to be a businessman. But for me, I have nothing. I don't know what I want to be. So I'm doubting myself, actually, because I don't know what is my strength. I do this a bit, do that a bit, but I'm not good in anything. So I have relented myself in this stage with the emphasis model as a self-doctor, which I always doubted myself. So I know that I want to apply for university, because I think that's the way that I can get a good job that can secure my future. So I decided to change, because my result is so bad. So I start to participate in class. I revise on the knowledge that I have left out for Malay or economy subject, and I find more exercise books to do to test all my understanding. And I became the one that always asks questions to teachers about those things I don't know, like the knowledge only. Okay, so I decided to change, but I have faced difficulties that time, because I easily felt sleepy when I study for the subject that I'm not interested. Because for example, history, what do you think when you read that? I really feel sleepy that time. So in order to overcome that, I sleep early. I force myself to sleep at 10 p.m. to make sure I have enough sleep. But I'm easily distracted by mobile phones, those things I like to do, computer games, books, novels, instruments that I play, like cello, piano, those things. I always spend time on that. So I really try hard to stay away from those things when I study. So I plan myself, I force myself, I need to study around 2 hours daily, at least on one subject a day. So when the my process of learning, and at that time I realized that I was so wrong, because my result is bad. It's not about my parents, they don't do anything, it's me. I didn't study in the first place. So I stopped blaming my parents, and I really I figured out what is my dream. I dream to open up my own hotel and resort. I know that's very hard, but I have set a goal for me to be a professional in hotel management. So I really like a quote by Mahatma Gandhi. He said, start changing yourself if you want to change the life around you. comes my stash tree. I paint the grass because of a poet brought by a Chinese poetry by Zhu Yi. He said it. 野火烧不尽,春风吹又生. It means not even a wildfire can destroy the grass because it grows again when the spring breeze blows. So I think grass is very strong features that I want to have that spirit in my future. I finally enrolled in university after I graduated from my SPM. So I have joined in a diploma in hotel management, but it's slightly different from other course because it's work-based learning. That is aiming to connect students to careers, which is students were going to their internship and study together, like doing it in the same time. So I have two weaknesses when I entered my university, which my English speaking skill is pretty poor, and because I am a Chinese native speaker, and people all around me they talk Chinese to me. I never speak English to anyone for my past 18 years, my first 18 years. I never speak English, even though I can understand English, but I never speak. So I have a hard time when it comes to presentation because I was so nervous at my first presentation in diploma that I need to present in front of 30x people, including my senior that time. And when I step there, I say good afternoon, then I cannot speak a word. I felt very embarrassed that time. So I talked to my program leader that time. He told me, don't afraid of making mistake because no pain, no gain. If you have gone through that shame, that period, then you will learn something from that. So my classmates, they encouraged me to try to speak English. So now I can communicate in English now. And it helps me a lot in my internship and the rest of my life. Yeah. So I like the quotes from Michael Jordan. He's like, don't be afraid to fail, be afraid not to try. So my second weakness is my time management. As I said earlier, that I read things slow in any language. I just very slow. I do things slow because my mindset is slow. I think very slow, and I'm a slow response person. Yeah. So it brings me a hard time when I'm in diploma because I need to undergo my internship, that time in Pullman Hotel, for 5 hours work daily I need to attend. And I only can arrive home after 10 p.m. daily. And on that time, I need to, contribute my time for internship, and I need to attend classes. So, and yet I need to squeeze my time for working on my assignments, and I need to study to pass my exams. So the things that I found really hard that time is that I need to hide all my emotions because I felt tired. I felt like very depressed that time, but I need to hide those emotions when I'm working in the hotel because I cannot bring those emotions into the workplace. But even though that's really hard, but it's a precious experience for me because I can learn how to manage my emotions, and I think that's a way I can learn how to cope with busy lifestyle that I may have in my future. So I was so frustrated that time. I think that I have no life compared with another course students because they can go like they can spend their time in student lounge, library, they can go karaoke, they can have many entertainment. But for me, I just my school to hotel and I go home, sleep, just that, nothing. So I was wondering that time, I taking the right course? Because they told me that's the first thing they conducted in that university. So I just think that am I choosing the wrong things, make the wrong decision. But luckily, my housemates and me, we are cheer up each other and we did not give up. I use the planner to plan on my time. I just think that's only 2 years. I just don't think of entertainment. I just do the things I'm doing now. Because if giving up, what for that I spent so much of time before? So finally, I graduated. I'm very happy with that. And so I have related myself in this niche with the ever since self-identity of struggle. Because I was struggle a lot in that time. So I've learned that school life is very different with the working life because there's no guidelines in work. They don't tell you what's right, what should you do. So I have collected some testimonies from my ex-colleagues, like the participant one. She said, I'm quite naive and I easily lose people. Participant two said that I do think so, but I'm carefully check every single detail and I'm forgetful. And participant, the third participant, she said that I'm easily get panicked when I encounter something I never experienced before. I partially agree with these comments because I think I'm naive, yeah, I'm forgetful, and I'm easily panicked, but I'm not really agree with the things she's saying. I'm a very detailed person because I'm forgetful. Yeah, so from those testimonies, I have drawn out my personal Flohaki Bindo, which arena is my open self, which people knows about me and I knows about me. I'm a quiet person, quiet, so, and I'm slow, easily get panic. I seldom share my feelings with others. And my blind spot, which represents the thing that I don't know, but how people view me is that they think that I'm naive. I usually take things for granted and maybe an arrogant person for that. And for the bucket area, which represents the things that I know but others don't know, is that I like to stay alone. I'm a meditative person. I think a lot. I don't want to be in spotlight. I don't want people to realize me. And I'm kind of stubborn and I'm a subjective person. But the unknown is represents the things that nobody knows. I think I may have a strong spirit in my future, and I hope I can manage myself to become a disciplined person. So I'm currently taking a bachelor in human resource management, which I think it will help in my future. So in order to gain more opportunity, I have took up a Japanese class when I was 17 years old. But I can pick up the content very quick because I watch anime since I was small. So it provided a chance for me to become a part-time Japanese home tutor. Japanese home tutor now to earn some extra pocket money for myself that I can pay for my daily expenses such as petrol rather than rely on my parents. So my next goal when after I graduated is to get a job in the hotel industry. And I want to apply for the test for Japanese language proficiency test, the M1 level, which is the highest level. I hope I can get it in next year. I will apply it. And if I have the chance after I graduated, I will further my study to take master in whether human resource management or I have extracted quotes from Haruki Murakami. He wrote in his book 1Q84, which stated, "Genzai to iu jujiro ni tatte, kakko o zetsujitsu ni tsume, kakko o kakikaeru yoni mirai o kakikomu." Hongdae Gupoda. It means stand at the crossroad, name present, and honestly looking back into the past. So I can create my future just like rewriting my past. It's actually really give me like hopes when I was frustrated that everyone can change. It's not late. Like, if you can honestly admit the things, the mistakes you've done, it's not not left for you to correct it, and you can be a better you. So this is my conclusion, and I have linked in four self-identities from Ellison's framework, which I explained in previous for self-doctor and struggler. But I have also related two identities, which is storyteller. I tell myself my past, my present, and my future, and I learn from that. So the last one is strategies, which I planning my route.